There are many reasons people need birds. Some are personal, others are quite practical.
Little birds like this, the Canada warbler is entirely insectivorous, and so if you lost this entire population, there'd be, I know it's hard to imagine, but there'd be a lot more mosquitoes.
Now, it is possible that you might be able to get a nice shot of a Canada warbler.
Len Reitsma and students from Plymouth State University are in the woods, not far from Hubbard Brook.
Nice.
Now what we would do is basically take this net down. Oh, get up. And go to the next bird that we haven't caught yet. And we'll do that until we catch every single male that we're currently monitoring.
Whew.
One of the main motivators for choosing the Canada warbler is the fact that it's in decline at about 4.1% per year in New Hampshire and about 2.7% regionally.
Okay, 75, 85. There's a lot of birds out here, but every single one fills its own niche. And so if you lose this species, then you're losing a food source for other species, and you're also losing a predator for many other species. Let's see. Well,
come here, Steve.
So throughout the breeding season, Reitsma works to piece together parts of an ecological puzzle. How many Canada warblers return to this area to raise families?
We have, I think, between 40 and 50 males up here on the upper plot.
What role do they play in an ecosystem?
We haven't figured out about how these remarkable little migratory birds do what they do. And I think it's important to both address some of these unanswered questions and to know that there's a whole lot more we'll never know.
And why are Canada warblers in decline?
Perhaps a statewide decline, and the decline in the species in general might be attributed to development or habitat fragmentation along the route from South America to here.